Hello and welcome to the Gamescast. Welcome to a slightly different video. Today we're playing X-Plane. The reason the intro was like that is because my shadow play doesn't record in the game. I have to start on a desktop view, then go into the game, and the frame rate actually drops if I tab out of X-Plane and goes back in. It's if I do it multiple times, my FPS will go down to about 20. I'm going to tell you what this video is about. But first of all, I'm just going to say, I've updated my processor since last time I recorded at X-Plane. So it should be really far superior to what it was. And the frame rate and stuff I hope is going to be far better. Let's start off by telling what this video is about. Well, first of all, 2016 has been a massive year for flight simulation. We have seen a massive amount of simulators released in 2016, and not just flight simulator, Euro Truck, train simulator, prepared 3D version 3. We've had Dovetail Flight School. We've had an absolute ton of simulators which have been announced in this year, and this plane has decided to pack up. Try and get it going again. Which is the Cessna 172 SP, I believe it's called. So, is there still anything to come in 2016? Well, yeah. X-Plane 11 has been announced and will get released by the end of this year. Flight Simulator 2016, the predecessor to Flight Simulator X, Flight Simulator 10, released a decade ago. So this, perhaps the two biggest releases, are still yet to come. X-Plane, let me take off. We're in, as you can see, Lucca, Nepal. Apparently one of the most dangerous airports in the world to fly into and land at. I'm going to just take off, so I'm going to concentrate a little bit. I'm not exactly a MLG at this simulator. I haven't played it. I played a little bit of it recently, but not too much. Let's just get a nice sort of lineup. Wanna get a couple of stages off flaps. You can see I'm just slowing down by the pure slope. We're gonna want full flaps, I think, for this. Oh my god. Let's just make sure my there you go. Wow, this is quite... let's just take off and then I will continue talking. One of the most dangerous airports around where Mount Everest is. So if you're going to Mount Everest and you're flying there, this is the airport you go to. You can see I've got various statistics and stuff up on my left-hand side. My frame rate, my altitude... not my altitude, my speed, my longitude, my latitude, and my fuel weight. Wow. How about this? This is fucking beautiful. Absolutely amazing. A quick flyby. Look at that. Hyper realistic. Wow. Oh wow. I've just downloaded the Asia scenery for X-Plane 10.5, is the version I'm currently on. And this is the Asia scenery. It's default with the game. Everything in this game is completely default. I'm just going to quickly show you my graphic settings so you know what you can expect from this video. Maybe you have slightly better settings and it doesn't look as good as what you're running. Sorry about that. This is just my current rendering options and stuff. Nothing fairly high. I reckon it's in the top. So I can't get it too much higher than this. But yeah, there you go. This is going to be a really casual video, guys. I'm not flying anywhere specific. I'm just going to fly around this local area, I think, and hopefully get out these clouds. And hopefully I don't, like, find my nose sticking out a mountain. Oh, wow! I just need to make sure I am climbing altitude, which I am not doing currently. So, ooh, wow. Okay. Hopefully I can pick up some speed. Let's try and follow this sort of coast relatively well. I'm going to take off all my flaps and hopefully just gain a little bit more speed. You can see on the left-hand side. Wow, look at this. This is amazing. So, 2017 has been a massive year for... 16, sorry. Has been the biggest year to date for flight simulators. We've had Prepared being released. And it was quite a success, to be honest. But the thing with Prepared I found is that basically it was the same as P3D version 2. No offense to anyone who's got it. I haven't played... I have played it before. I've played it at a mate's house. I don't personally own it. It is better than Flight Simulator. But I don't think it's worth the money from P3D version 2. Unless it's a free upgrade, which I can't remember. So I do apologise. I'm not really a Prepared user. Two massive announcements. The first big announcement is, of course, X-Plane 11. In fact, yeah, let's go X-Plane 11. Let me just quickly run you through what's in X-Plane 11, from what we know anyway, so far. There's currently... it's a completely redesigned user interface, okay? This user interface here, which you can see here, is not... going to exist. It looks a lot more polished, a lot cleaner, a lot nicer. Any of you guys who have used either Rex Essentials Plus for FSX or Active Sky Next, or if you know what their user interfaces look like, it's a similar style to that. It is just a lot easier, and the whole user interface has been redesigned. Every single element, every single menu you can get to from here or at the start of the game has been very, very heavily modified. It looks much nicer, and it looks a lot more user-friendly, and it gives you the amount of power this current user interface gives you, which is complicated by most people's standards, including myself. I found this quite a complicated user interface. So, X-Plane 11, what are the new features apart from the overhaul of a user interface? Well, I'm just reading off a list, so bear with me if I stutter a little bit. For 3D cockpits inside the plane, like this for example, have been completely redesigned, a better resolution, higher resolutions, an overall nicer look. More buttons work inside the cockpit, for example. Look, these things here don't work at the moment. They will do in the next update. The doors open, the windows don't open, they will work, all those kind of things. And that's for every single plane which is currently in X-Plane. Let me just show you a very quick look of the current aircraft list. There's sort of general aviation and the heavy metal planes here. There's a glider here, the helicopters as well, and the mega planes. I think that's pretty much most of the standard planes. Oh, and here you go, these as well. I'm not sure, I think it's F4 Phantom standard. So that's been completely overhauled and redesigned. There are new aircrafts as well, which we don't know too much information about. However, there is an Airbus A320, I believe, coming into the game, which I think is going to be really, really cool. Designed by the guys at X-Plane. New lighting, sounds and explosions. The lighting is something they focused heavily on. They weren't overly keen with the lighting on this current, on the current sort of X-Plane, which this is. So yeah, the new lighting they've really heavily focused on. I've seen that and it looks spectacular. It looks beautiful. It looks incredible. The new sim, from the small clips which I have seen of it. And if you think this looks good, it's going to look even better. Realistic avionics. For example, the current default aircrafts in X-Plane are not massively realistic. They're kind of just very much mediocre. You know, they're not like... They're just not that realistic, to be honest. They're just very mediocre. That's the only way I think to describe it. I think, you know... the things like the sat nav, what am I fucking talking about? Things like all the avionics, the navigation, the CDUs and stuff. I mean, this is fairly good. This is good. This was added in 10.5, I think. CDU was added in 10.5. It's made by a third party developer, but it's it's sort of been licensed to be used by X-Plane. It is someone who works very closely, and it is a free update. It's not like it's not paid or anything. I imagine X-Plane pay this guy. I think he might even be part of the X-Plane sort of development team and stuff as well. Let's make a 90-degree turn towards these mountains over here. I've told you that we are in Nepal, so middle of Asia, really, I think. If my knowledge serves me right, I might be completely wrong. Let's have a quick look at the world map. Where that is, planet map, there you go. Sent on aircraft, there you go. Sort of middle-ish Asia, I guess. That's where we are currently. Not too far away from Japan. And this is where Mount Everest is. This Nepal airport is the closest airport to Mount Everest, I think. I might be wrong though, so don't take my word on it. Things like, you know, in the commercial jets we currently have in X-Plane, the CDU is realistic. It's like what you get in the actual plane, rather than basically what you can do at the moment, which is just simply set waypoints and stuff, which I gotta say really is not that fun. I don't find it fun. I only mess around in those planes because I kind of feel, well, that's all I can really do, because they're not really realistic. They're just very much mediocre. They look fantastic, everything works, there's a lot of clickable buttons and stuff, and the buttons you click genuinely do something, and the failures look fantastic and everything. But the avionics don't really work, they're not like the real thing. The only thing you can really do in that airplane is put waypoints. You can put waypoints, that's about it really. You don't really have a flight computer or anything like that. And if you do, I've missed it in all the time I've been playing X-Plane. The new avionics system stuff looks like what you get in the real aircraft, which I can't wait. I think it's going to be really cool. Another thing they've done is realistic airports. At the moment, the airports, they did have modelled some airports in X-Plane, but not all of them. They've modelled, well, I say not all of them, they're never going to be able to model all of them. But a lot of the main airports and stuff, they haven't really modelled, like, they're mediocre. The new version of X-Plane, or X-Plane 11, is going to have live vehicles, it's going to have ground services, fuel trucks. The fuel trucks, on your request, will come to your aircraft, which I think is going to be awesome. I can't wait for that. They're going to come to your aircraft and they're going to refuel your plane. They're going to put the fuel on. They're going to load on the luggage. All the things kind of like Ground Service Extreme for FSX, but it's free for X-Plane. Like a lot of things in X-Plane are free. They come with the game. For example, this camera system, which is far better than any FSX camera system, but far better than EasyDock even, you know, and it's just easy to use. It's nice. You can create your own custom views like that. You can switch extremely quickly by whatever button you desire to press as your sort of view set. It's so much easier. It really is. What else have I do? New buildings and roads for Europe. At the moment, hang on, let me just take a drink. At the moment, you'll notice, doesn't matter where you are in the world, well, where you are in Europe or America, all the houses are like a little American ranches and stuff, which is cool. I like American ranches, but it's not realistic for Europe. You can tell where you are simply from the scenery or whatever, but there, it's nothing, you know, it's not, it doesn't blow your mind or anything. So, you know, that's just how it is, I guess. But now they are, have developed new buildings, European buildings. They, at the moment, they look German, but they will be, but they will be expanding that. And the reason they look German is because they have to start from somewhere. And for a lot of Europe, if you look at, you know, obviously Germany, not so France, but Amsterdam, Switzerland, and the areas around Germany, a lot of the buildings are fairly German themed, or European themed. If you think of a European building, it's not like what we have in the UK, or what they, or a lot of what they have in France or Italy. So I imagine with updates and community made products, that will dramatically change. Things like fog and stuff, they've massively changed as well. It looks so much more realistic. It is unbelievable how much more realistic this, their new fog engine works. This is all revealed at the Cosford Flight Simulator Show 2016, if you're wondering. As we go into some cloud, which is fine, we're just going to straighten up a bit, what means I need to go inside the cockpit so I actually know what level is for my plane. Hopefully we should come out of this cloud fairly soon. We are climbing altitude, I think. Yeah, we are slowly, and just let's just climb a little bit more, like so. Yeah, there you go, that's a bit better. Oh my god. Wow, we're just surrounded by clouds. It's quite incredible. I wonder what flyby looks fairly. Oh, you should come out into, here we go, but open fairly soon, like so. So yeah, that's really, it is a new product. It's a separate product what X-Plane have developed. It's still going to be 64-bit. And you can see how well this runs on my computer at the moment. I've tried loads and a variety of planes. I haven't just tried one plane. I've tried payware planes and stuff as well on this. And my frame rate, it's constantly at least 50 FPS, as you can see here, which is incredible. We are in a very densely populated scenery area, if you like, with all the mountains, etc. So there's a lot going on, which pushes the frame rate down a bit, but I haven't got below 30 yet. And well, this is X-Plane and how it looks, so much better than I think any other sim you can get. It just, the scenery on this sim is unprecedented. It's incredible. I honestly don't know how they've managed to make the scenery look this good. It looks completely phenomenal. It's breathtaking scenery. It really, really is. It's just stunning. Everything. I mean, if you took a picture now, you might not be able to, you probably wouldn't know if this is real life or not. Is that good? I am going to take a quick screenshot, I think. I forgot the screenshot button for Steam. Maybe I can't take a screenshot. I think I might be able to take one here though. Take a screenshot, shift and space. Okay, hopefully I'm not. Let's try this. Okay, taking a screenshot. I don't know where that comes out to, but we'll find out soon enough. I wonder where Mount Everest actually is. World's tallest mountain? Whereabouts is it? I have absolutely no idea. I wonder if it says on the local map. probably this one here, maybe. So one turn, so practically north. So let's just get my bearings right. Means I'll have to go over this mountain, which is going to be fun. The new flight simulator. Well, that's quite a big talking point as well. That is also coming out at the end of this year. Which, bearing in mind, is only really, well, realistically, a couple of months away. I imagine it will be ready by Christmas released. It would be stupid of Dovetail and Lamina Research not to release their simulators by Christmas. I imagine they obviously know, Dovetail know X-Plane are releasing a new sim, and, you know, X-Plane know that Dovetail are releasing a sim as well. Or Lamina Research, sorry, are releasing a sim as well. So I imagine that's why they've decided to take... I imagine that both sims will get released within 2 weeks of each other being released. So that will be really cool. I can't wait for that. The new flight simulator is 64-bit, which is obviously something X-Plane has been for a while. The new flight simulator also has partners such as Orbex and A2A default within the game. The game will come, or the game sim, whatever you want to call it. I'm calling it a game, but it is a sim. I know that. The sim also comes with jets and stuff already in the game, which weren't in the game before, and I think much better. FMCs, the default jets in this sim doesn't have, in Flight Simulator X, doesn't have an FMC. It has a kind of a mediocre sort of, well, it is just mediocre, you know. It just has like a mediocre sort of autopilot, which is, you know, really basic. Anyone can pick up, well, I imagine anyone can pick it up. I might be wrong about that. Wow, this looks good. Let's do a quick flyby, because like, we can pretty much zoom in to all this sort of stuff. Look at that. So realistic. All those bumps are real as well. They're not just kind of like painted on, which is like really, really cool. I don't know how X-Plane or Lamina Research... I'm sorry if I keep calling it X-Plane. I don't know how Lamina Research are going to make the scenery even better. Maybe they're not. There is a guy who creates HD mesh, which I'm not using here. I do have Europe and part of America in, I think I have a San Francisco airport in HD mesh, and I have, I'm not sure if it's, I think it's mainly the UK I have in HD mesh. I'm not sure how much of Europe I have in the HD mesh. But it makes, you know, overall, it does obviously slightly decrease your FPS, but not really by any noticeable amount. I wonder what altitude we're at. We might even be too high for... What are we? 15... 16,000 feet, maybe? Let's find out. Yeah, 16,000-17,000 feet. Quite amazing. In fact, it probably says on this, doesn't it? I don't actually know how to use this. Let's have a look, see what I can do, if I can press any buttons, menu. Okay. That hasn't worked, has it? We haven't heard... You've heard quite a bit about both simulators. Well, we've heard a lot more about Dovetail's new simulator, which is Flight Simulator 2016, and we have Lamina Research's X-Plane, which got announced on Saturday the 8th of October, I think, if that's correct. Whichever Saturday is closest to the 8th of October, that's when it got announced. So we don't know that much, but go to the xplane.com website to find out more about the xplane. They also have a video. If you search on YouTube, xplane xplane conference, I think, or just type in xplane 11 announcement or something into YouTube, you should see two videos about half an hour each or something. One's like 27, one's 23 minutes long or something. And Lam and Research have done a whole sort of hour of X-Plane and pretty much the same what I've said, but in far more detail. And they've also got screenshots and all that kind of stuff. There's also an X-Plane 11 sort of lightning and fog trailer, which is very widely accessible just on the X-Plane YouTube channel. We haven't seen any type of footage from Flight Simulator or anything, and that was fairly similar to Flight School as well. You know, it was coming closer and closer to the release date, I think back in April or whenever it was. And we didn't see anything up until sort of, you know, the last minute. Then we saw quite a lot of things suddenly popping up and all that kind of stuff. So, you know, it's obviously something, Dovetail like to do, don't really like to sort of show too much of a pre-release of their products or whatever. And, you know, it's obviously entirely their choice of what they decide to show about their products in its sort of beta stages. But I'm really excited about end of this year. I'll be picking up both simulators on the day of launch, and I will be doing videos and stuff, and I'm sure Reef will be doing videos as well. So, you know, it should be a very fun year for the flight simulation community. And it's, you know, it's, I've put a lot of hours into Flight Simulator. I've probably played like things like F1 for a lot longer than I have played F1 for longer than I have Flight Simulator. But I've probably played more hours on Flight Simulator, I'd say, maybe. Well, game by game, I definitely have. I've played more hours on Flight Simulator Rex than sort of any other game. But, you know, over sort of 5 F1... Was it 5? No, 6 F1 games that have been released by Codemasters, I've played, you know, probably a bit more hours on those. But yeah, I mean, X-Plane, you know, I did a video about a year ago or something, and I think I labelled it, "Is X-Plane your simulator?" I was like, well, I'm not really sure. How the best way to describe X-Plane for me at the moment is, it's just not... Everything's there, but it's not. There's a pretty good X-Plane community. There's like 3,500 community-made add-ons for X-Plane, which are completely free. You can also buy add-ons and stuff as well, obviously. Are we still going up? We can't. Jeez, we are. The ground's just getting a little bit closer. We were getting pushed right a little bit as well. The physics in X-Plane are better than FSX as well, and I think the planes are probably a little bit easier to fly. I mean, like, if there is a way where I can show you the physics, if I don't, like, completely crash, which is entirely possible. Show flight model, there we go. You can see the flight model and how when I do things, you can see the forces reacting. Quite incredible, really. I think there's different sort of different stages of the flight model. You can see how aerodynamics work, which I think is just so cool. Like that as well. That is just... That's really cool. I love how you can do that, you know, just like switch between how X-Plane looks and stuff. Because it does look really cool. I mean, look how close to the ground it looks like we are, but we're really not. We are thousands of feet up in the air. It's quite incredible, really. Hopefully we can... The wind's really picked up as well. I don't know what the wind speed is, but I imagine it's quite exciting. I can get it up on this somewhere. I have the wind speed. I'm just going to have a atmospheric weather. Yeah, okay. I think... Sorry if you guys have seen it and I've clicked the wrong thing. Wind speed, yeah, you can see it's... What? Oh, God. Oh, no, mayday. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, dear. Oh, well, that wasn't successful, was it? Oh, no. I wonder what airport I'm going to start at. This... Wow. This is pretty awesome. Another thing I love about X-Plane is the ability to do stupid things. Right, let me show you what I mean. So, let's put my plane there. That's ridiculous. 26,000 feet up. Fucking hell. 60,000 feet at the speed of, well, doesn't really matter. And then you can literally just make the aircraft drop like a stone. I was going to say like a plunge, but... I don't even know what that means. I look how fast I'm going. You can just see on the left-hand side. You want to look at the true airspeed. So it's absolutely crazy. I don't know how tall Mount Everest is, but I think it's pretty fucking tall. I'm currently going 500. Let's have a quick look at this. Look at this. Meow. I'm losing altitude fairly quickly. Pretty MLG. Let's level out the plane fairly soon. I don't really want to crash into too many of these mountains, but I do want to see which one's the biggest ass mountain. See if I can identify Mount Everest. Well, I imagine it might be that one over there. Yeah, I don't actually know which one Mount Everest is. Let's just have a quick look on the local map. I might be able to... Oh, no. Oh, there you go. That... Yeah, that obviously isn't gonna... Well, basically, this is telling me all the mountains are fucking high. Yeah, I'm not actually sure which one Mount Everest is. What the hell is that? Oh, these are like deers or something, aren't they? Yeah, lots of deers. You have like deers running around. You might have seen them earlier. I'm not sure if I had them. Oh, that's interesting. If I can probably find out which is a sort of tallest mountain just by zooming in, because it kind of goes a little bit meh on me. Might be. Possibly this one over here, isn't it? Yeah, this one here is probably Mount Everest, so... Let's plot my plane just there. Hit the X. I might crash instantly. The one I'm over now is probably Mount Everest, which is quite cool. And you can also, another really cool thing about this, you can do things like water landings and stuff in this game, and they're properly good as well. They're not like, you know, bad water landings. But yeah, this has just sort of been a kind of a discussion video. So I'm sorry if I've sort of yabbered on a little bit. Let's try and land this plane on Mount Everest. Is that even possible? Probably not. Landing a Cessna is extremely difficult, by the way. Oh my god. Like, it is, like... Because it's not that easy to slow this plane down, means it is very difficult to do.
Oh my god, this is going to be quite fun. I'm kind of just like not really losing that much speed. Unless I go uphill, you don't really lose that much speed in this plane, which I am losing quite a bit of speed now, even though it appears like I'm going downhill, which I am. It's, well, it's not very steeply though. Hopefully I can land on like this piece here, because that would be good. The wind's not too bad in this area either, I don't think. But I am getting pushed right a little bit. There's quite a bit of turbulence. And here we go. Land before I sort of hit the right side of this mountain as well, which you know, I gotta say, that would be nice. Wow! Oh god. It's crazy, I'm still going really quickly, but it doesn't feel like it. Ah, come on, land, you piece of junk! Ah! I just don't want to crash, you know? Oh fuck it, I'm gonna risk it. Oh shit. Oh shit. This isn't good, is it? Oh god, this really is not good. The plane is now broken. Flaps and stuff still work. Hang on. Now why is that working? That's odd. Oh, maybe the... That's strange. Well, maybe because I went a lot faster is kind of fixed it. Anyway, we don't want engine power because I want to land. There we go, we might be at slow enough speed. We're going to have to bunny hop this little piece here and land uphill. Oh, we crashed at 59.74 miles per hour or 38 knots, which, you know, or 50 something knots actually, I think. But anyway, that's been this sort of little me messing around on X-Plane. I hope you have, you know, enjoyed it or found this partly interesting or whatever. Even things like this, look at that. Oh, I didn't even realise it did that. As the engine spin it, does it create more dust the faster it spins? No. Hey, well, that's quite cool. Anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you again soon. That's one of those deers I was talking about. Bye-bye.